Good evening. God is good.
All the time.
God is good. Well, my name is Dennis Carter, and it's a blessing to have you here as this candlelight service. And I just pray that each and everyone feels God's presence. And I know I met one of Murray's friends. Well, I didn't meet him. He led me here into town at 53 miles per hour on the low road. He was going really slow. We need to talk to that guy. But anyway, it's a blessing to have you here. And while I catch my breath, we're going to have the lighting of the Advent candle, and the Houston family will do that for us.
The scripture tonight is Isaiah 9, 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nations, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest. As people exult when dividing plunder, for the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulder, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, and from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This night is a night to remember, a night when home broke in on us, a night when we were not forgotten or alone or abandoned. This night is the night when here and there become one, when past and future combined in a breathless present. This is the night when we are home, in ourselves, in this family, in the God who loved us enough to walk beside us.
We gather in the night to proclaim light. We shake off despair and embrace hope. We set aside conflict and choose peace. We push away despair by claiming joy. We overcome hate by rising into love. Because this night, we know, even in the shadows of our doubts, we know that we are loved. That's what it means to be home.
We light these candles, hoping to become the light, hoping to radiate light by how we live. We light these candles to create a space called home in this place, in our place, in inner places. We light these candles to declare that unto us a Savior is born, who is Christ the Lord. Welcome home by angels singing and shepherds kneeling, welcomed home by those like us who have worshiped for thousands of years. Welcomed home again tonight, right here, right now in us. It's time to be home.
Thank you so much. At this time, our special music will be Kurt Krupp.
night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till He appeared and the soul felt its worth. The thrill of hope, the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on your knees, oh, hear the angel voices. Oh, night divine, oh, night when Christ was born. The slave is our brother, and in His name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise His holy name. Christ is the Lord. Let every layman praise Him.
This time of the call to worship. Unto us the Christ is born. O come, let us worship Him. And at this time we'll be singing, O come, all ye faithful, verses 1 through 3. That's in the United Methodist hymnal, number 234, or up on the screen.
Thank you.
time we'll have special music. The women will be singing. Now at this time, the scripture reading will be from Matthew chapter 1, verses 18 to 23. Karen, it's your word.
Now the birth of Jesus, the Messiah, took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what has been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel, which means God is with us."
At this time, we'll be singing, O Come, Emmanuel. And it'll be verses 1, 2, 4, and 6 on 2:11 in the United Methodist Hymnal or on the screen. This time we'll have the scripture reading from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. John Bryant will share with us.
In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judah, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was the descendant from the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn.
This time was special music from Anita and Mark Hoffman.
Noel, 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 Noel. us all with one accord, sing praises to our heavenly Lord.
God hath made heaven and earth of naught, and with his blood mankind was bought.
Time we'll have the reading. Pat Allen will read to us Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 20.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told them.
At this time, we'll be singing Angels We Have Heard on High, verses 1 through 3, and you'll find that on 238 of the United Methodist Hymnal.
Thank you.
Would you please bow with me as we go to the Lord? Gracious and loving God, we thank you for loving us so much. As we celebrate tonight, as we reflect on the greatest gift of all, Jesus, our Lord and Savior. His birth, but not only his birth, but the reason that he came. He came to die for our sins. So gracious God, I just ask that you would give me the words tonight, that they'd be your words and not mine. Because your words never return void. We just thank you and praise you again. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen. As I look at this Christmas Eve evening, I've had a couple of children that have taught me quite a bit this year. I titled it, It's About the Presence and Not the Presence. Well, we have a resident theologian named Drew. She is 5 years old, and twice during children's time, she has told all of us, it's not about Santa, but it's about Jesus. You know, and that's so true, and I want to thank her mother and father for doing such a good job with Drew. But you know, many times, even though we know that, our focus isn't always there. Maybe you've heard the story about the woman shopping in the mall, and she came across a nativity scene. She said, I can't believe it. Now they're even bringing religion into Christmas. In Matthew, in chapter 1, in a dream, an angel sharing with Joseph that he is to marry Mary. And this son that she will have, his name will be Jesus, which means Savior, because he will save his people. Also, the angel said his name will be called Emmanuel, which means God is with us. And Matthew does a good job with that, because also at the very last words of Jesus in the book of Matthew is, he reminds them in Matthew 28, I will be with you always. God's presence is with us. No matter what we're going through, God is there. God will never leave you. God will never forsake you. But you know, many didn't understand that. They were even arguing who was going to get the best seat on the night that Jesus betrayed at the Last Supper. Not everyone gets it or understands. And I had the opportunity to witness that with another child. That's my grandson, Ezra. You see, Ezra turned 2 on the 22nd, just a couple of days ago. I was not able to go to his birthday party. Betty and I wasn't able to because I did a graveside that Saturday. And my mom, which is a great-grandmother, was saying how great he was and how he opened each present and made so much over them, even the clothes, and he would talk for minutes about the clothes. So this was the opportunity for Betty and I to see this prodigy of a child. And you'll really laugh after you hear the rest of the story. Well, this first present, he ripped it open and always just so excited. And then the next present, Betty did a wonderful job of wrapping and it had clothes in it. And he unwrapped it and we're thinking, oh, he's going to talk about the clothes just like he did Saturday. He goes, oh no. Picks up and oh no, oh no. Well, our children said, why don't you go ahead and let Ezra unwrap his Christmas presents, since you guys are going to, and that was actually his birthday on the 22nd, since you're going to go home back to Ellsworth. And we said, okay, that'd be fine. I don't know where he came up with this, but each present, now he's shaking before he opens it, and opens it and just enjoys it so much. The last present was in a sack. You already know what's in there, right? And he opens it up. He goes like this. I mean, we got pictures. He's just throwing these clothes. He's so upset. And I'm thinking, oh, no, Ezra. And I pick up this shirt, and it's a cute little black T-shirt, and it's got three dinosaurs on it, green, red, and blue. And I thought, oh, look this, Ezra. And he looks at the shirt, and he looks at me, and he says, I don't wear black. I mean, true story. I'm in church. Yes, Ezra didn't get it, but I want us to all to get about the presence of the Lord. We, this last month, we've been lighting Advent candles. The first one is hope. Even in difficult times, and we've been through some difficult times in this last year, because of Jesus, we have hope. It's not the end. The next week was peace. And we've had people that have heard some difficult things in this last year. But because of Jesus, we can have peace. The pink candle is the candle for joy. In that scripture that we had that week was from Philippians chapter 4. You know, the rejoice, again, I say rejoice. I had a couple come to me that has heard some difficult news. And they said, you know, when we heard that and we reflected on Apostle Paul, he didn't allow his circumstances to overtake him. That he could still have joy. Because even the worst thing that ever could happen to us is not the last thing. As believers in Christ, that we will see Jesus. And they said, we have joy. And the last one is love. I remember growing up in a little church that I grew up in, Nevada, Missouri, and a little scripture said, God is love. And doesn't our world need love today? We definitely need love. When I look at also the scripture from Luke, in chapter 2, verses 1 through 7, where they said there wasn't any room in the inn. You know, Jesus wants to be your Lord and Savior. Desires to have a relationship with you. Won't you please make room for Him to be your Lord and Savior? And then the last reading in Luke. Who was the first people that God had the angels share about the Messiah, the Savior of the world? It was shepherds. You see, shepherds in those days were the lowest of the low. They were unclean. They weren't even welcome to go into the temple or the synagogue. And then I believe the reason that God went to the shepherds to remind us all that He desires for us to know Him. To know of His love, of His forgiveness, and live that. There's nothing that you have done that is too great for God's grace. God's grace is greater than all sin. Let us pray. Gracious God, I just thank You and praise You for Your presence. No matter what we're going through, You are there. You lead us, You guide us, You direct us. And dear Lord, that You want us to make room for You. In Revelations 3:20, it says that Jesus is knocking on the door of our hearts. I pray that we'd all open that door and let Him in and sup with us. And God, I thank You. Because You're the Lord of all people. They didn't go to royalty first, but they went to shepherds. The lowest of the low. Because all people are significant. All people are important. And dear Lord, I pray that each one of us would receive you as Lord and Savior. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen. Now at this time, we'll have special music Alice is going to share with us. Stewards, please come forward. And we'll prepare the table. And this is an open table. As God's grace is for all, this is an open table. This is the Lord's table. And we have gluten-free if you need it also. And not only will you we have you come forward, and we'll have two stations for communion, but we'll also have candles for you to pick up, because we'll have the candlelight after communion. And if we do not have enough candles prepared, the ushers, there's candles back there. They already give me a thumbs up. I tell you what, I was overwhelmed in Kannapolis. There was way more people than we prepared for. And I think the same maybe here today. I don't know. No, we got thumbs up, so we're good. All right. Well, on that night, the night that Jesus was betrayed in the upper room, he took the bread, he blessed it, and broke it, said, "This is my body. Take, eat, and do this in remembrance of me." And after the meal, it would have been the third cup, the cup of redemption. Jesus took it and blessed it and says, "This cup is a new covenant. My blood shed for the forgiveness of your sins. Take, drink, and do this in remembrance of me." Let us pray. Gracious God, we just thank you and praise you. We ask that you bless these elements and just draw us closer to you, that we'd have a greater understanding of your love and your forgiveness, and that you'll never leave us nor forsake us. So, dear Lord, just minister to each and every heart tonight. We thank you and praise you. In Jesus' precious name, amen. And there's candles on both sides after you take. So would you please come? Thank you. all received. God, we thank you and praise you. Continue to minister our hearts as we reflect on your love and grace that you have for all the world. In Jesus' precious name, amen. At this time, we'll be singing Silent Night. We'll be sharing the light. And would the ushers please come forward? We'll be taking the light off of the Christ candle. And if you would you please stand as we sing the song? And when we light, we'll be bringing the light to you. And then you'll take your candle to the side and then move it over. And then the next person comes to the side.
Oh, yes.
look around and see all the light. As John said, Jesus is the light of the world. Jesus dispels all the darkness. So at this time, you can extinguish your candle and we'll bring the lights on and sing Joy to the World. I just want to thank everyone that made this possible. I want to thank you all and for your sharing, and what a blessing. We do have a Savior that reigns. His name is Jesus. And I send you out all in His power. Power of God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name, amen and amen. And Merry Christmas to you.